So hello everyone, in the last video we have seen that how we can register the user using the Firebase authentication. We have sent the user to the onCreate method, and then we have checked for the email and password and all. So in this video we will see how we can send the user name to our Firebase database, I mean the Firebase Firestore. So here you can see that we have created this four method, right? Four edit text. So this first one is email, then these two are passwords, and this is the full name. So let's see in this video how we can send the user full name to our Firebase auth. Now there was one more thing, that if there is an error, so the error sign is shown, but I think that is kind of useless, because we don't prefer to use custom error, you know, that highlighting text, or custom error button, we don't like to use it. So leave it. Without a further ado, let's get started. So first, what we have to do is we have to go to our browser and get to the app, which we are creating, and click here Cloud Firestore. So now in your case, what will happen is that here it will not be made an active. I mean, you have to click for activate, okay, and set the country or the region by default and click on enable. So after that, come here and click on rules, and here in the rules, first of all, you will see when you will make it activate, so you will see here the value is by default, this whole value will be written as false, so you have to change that and type this one. Okay, now just click on go to docs. So after clicking on this, you will come to this page. Now click on get started for Android. So after clicking on this page, you will come to this page. Now let's just go ahead and scroll this. So coming down in the base part here, and here you can see that Cloud Firestore option is there. So what we have to do is we have to add this implementation to our app. So copy this one. Let's come to Android Studio. And here in the Android Studio, come to build.cradle and add that implementation here. Okay, now make sure to type implementation here. Okay, and make sure to give the version number as well. So we have used the auth version number. So make just remember that auth version number and this Firestore version number will be same. So here the auth version number is 11.8.0. So we'll keep that as 11.8.0 itself. Okay, now let's just go ahead and click on sync now. So let's wait for the Gradle build to complete. Okay, so here you can see that the Gradle build has been successfully complete. Now coming back to sign up fragmenter.java and close this one. Now here what we have to do is in the check email and password which we have created here. Wait, let's first minimize all these, because these are taking space. Okay, so here you can see that we have created this check email and password. So let's go to this function. Okay, so this is the function here. So here what we have to do is we have to add the Firestore. We have to send the name, right? So first what we have to do is we have to create a map. Okay, and here first parameter will be the object, and second parameter will be the string. And here let's suppose that is user data. This will be equal to new hash map, and this will be as it is. Okay, so basically here what will happen if the task is successful, I mean the user has successfully registered, so his username will be sent to the Firebase Firestore, and it will be stored in the database. So map object we have created. Now let's send that. So user data dot put. Okay, and we'll pass that user data in the username parameter. So username comma user data dot get text dot get text. Okay, so we are getting error here. So let's change this to full name, because we have to pass that. So full name dot get text dot to string. Okay, so we have to pass this full name here. Now we will create a Firebase Firestore, because we have to store that in the Firestore. So let's create that variable here above here and name that as private Firebase Firestore, and same Firebase Firestore, and let's initialize this as well. So Firestore equals to Firebase Firestore dot get instance. Okay, now what we have to do is we have to come here again here and let's add this in the collection in our database. So we'll pass that by Firestore dot collection and we'll pass that in the user collection. Okay, now dot add and we will pass the full name here. Now again dot add on complete listener and here it will create a new on complete listener documentary and here first of all we'll give the semicolon because it will show a red line so it won't be good. Okay, so now here we have to again check whether the task is successful or not. So if task dot is successful, so we will do something. I mean, first let's comment this, let's make the else part as well. And so basically if the task is successful, so we will cut this part here from here and we will go ahead and simply paste it here. And if the task is not successful, then we will just copy this thing, Control C, and we will paste it here. This was the else of the, this else was of and this is of task is successful. Okay, so I'll just cut this one from here and let's change the button color again because we need to set it to enabled. So we'll copy this from here. Now we'll paste this enabled option here. Now we have pasted this enabled option here just because we want the user to click again, because if the task is not successful, it means that user hasn't registered yet. So we want the user to click on the button again so that he can again try again for the registering. So here it is showing error, so press alt enter. Let's sort out this error, remove all these and simply write color.rgb. okay, and let's pass here white color, so 255. Okay, so we have successfully done the user, we have sent the user to our app. Now let's run our app. Okay, so I have run the app here. You can see the app is running here. You can see this app is running. Okay, now let me show you that. See, we haven't entered the correct pattern for the email. So let's test our app whether it shows the error or not. Then I've entered the name. Now we'll store this in the our Firebase Firestore. Now I've entered the wrong password. Now let's click on sign up. Okay, so we have entered the wrong email, so it shows that. Now let's enter the correct. Okay, so we have entered the correct pattern for the email, but we haven't entered the same password. So let's see whether it detects the password or not. Okay, so it says the password does not match. So let's enter the correct password. So now we have entered the correct password. Now let's click on sign up. Okay, so our app has crashed. So now just make one changes here. Now here I have typed the full name. So just change this to this field, that user data, this one. Okay, now let's run our app again. Okay, so we can see that registered is successful. So this was all in this video. I'll meet you in the next video. Thank you. Okay, so just one thing to show here. I haven't shown this. So let's come to this Cloud Firestore and let's see whether our email has been added or not. Okay, so we can see that our username has been successfully added here, which is the one username which we have sent it, this Amit Kumar. So this is all, and in the authentication the email will be added. So just want to show this, that the username has been successfully added.